Yes, we would typically we would start with mapping of duty cycle of the vehicle, how are the events happening in the driving pattern. Let's say typically if we in a city environment, how much is the braking, how much is acceleration. So that kind of mapping is done upfront to understand what kind of benefit we can really achieve. So we don't commit that we can prove or we can save fuel in all kinds of driving behaviors. That's not possible. But we are targeting a specific city application and that too buses where we have a city driving pattern and there's a lot of braking, a lot of acceleration. That's what we need for hybrid system to work properly. In terms of tuning, what we would have to tune compared to, let's say, if a 9-ton bus or a 16-ton bus, you would just tune the acceleration profile and the braking profile because of the kinetic energy, which is different for different tonnage of vehicle. That's the only tuning we have to do.
Okay, makes sense. Let's say from a development cycle perspective, let's pick an example like a Tata 1512, right? Or any, I mean, I'm guessing the applications here are not just not just in the for buses, they're also for trucks, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, it can be installed in this, but as I said earlier, the trucks, if you ply on highways, you won't be able to commit fuel saving compared to what we'll get in city. So, but if you operate a truck in city, we can definitely expect a higher fuel savings.
Because mainly the idea of saving energy is in the area of regen and stop and go traffic where there's usually major fuel consumption happens, right?
Absolutely, yeah.